think he's decent. Holy, it's a big one. Y'all, there's that wild pig right there. Look, there he is. Oh, shit. You want some piece of me? Got one, guys. Holy, it's a big one. Wow. Awesome. Golly. Y'all, I can't be too loud. There's three guys fishing right beside me here, and there's another person on the dock over there, so I didn't want to make a big fuss, but that is a tank for a pond on the Swank. Y'all, I'm out here just to see if my paddleboard will still hold air, and paddleboard's doing fine. And if y'all are fishing a pond and it has grass that looks like that in it, throw a Swank. It will come through that grass and it will attract huge bites, guys. That is a tank for a pond. That's the small version of the Swank, guys. It's a 66X. I think it's 5/8 of an ounce. Pretty much maxing out my little Dobbin Sierra, but I got it on 8-pound fluoro and my Cast King Zephyr, and it's handling it just fine. Yo, look at this. There's a wild pig looking at me. There's a hog right there. A freaking good-sized hog. Look at that. Can you hear him breathing at me? There's my pig. And there's a wild pig right there. I'm depending on you. Tell me the truth. Mama just hung her head and said, son, Papa was a rolling stone. Well, another one on the Swank, guys. You can probably see some of that grass right there. I'm just running that Swank over the top of it and just letting it get hung up every now and then jerking it free. Looking for a bigger bite than that, but at least I got one. Another one. Tiny. Saw that Swank. Hey mama, is it true what you say that Papa never worked a day in his life? And mama, there's another one. That might be bigger. That might be bigger. Yeah, that might be bigger, guys. Unless he's got a lot of grass on him. Oh no. Oh, I just had him hook funny. That's why. He just swiped at it. Still on the Swank, guys. I'm telling you. If you've got grass and you got a little wind, throw that Swank. There's another one. That one might be better too. Not bad. There's another one. That's a big one. Hey, mama, Not bad, guys, not bad. Oh, we got off. Dang it. Got one, guys. Feels decent. That would be why. It's because it's a turtle. I'm getting pretty good at catching turtles lately. I don't know how you're gonna get off of there. Bunch of bass and a turtle. Guys, there's one. There's one. There's a head shaker. Yeah, buddy. There's one. I mean, this is still a small size crankbait, guys, but it's still like conventional weight in terms of how big it is. It makes all these fish feel so much bigger than what they are. That's still a really good pond bass though, guys. Don't get it wrong. That's like a pound and a half, maybe two. Probably a pound and a half. Guys, there's another one. I don't think he's very big. Oh, not bad. There's one. There's another one, guys. That one feels better. He's just hooked the funny. Oh man, he's only got one eye. Somebody's given him the business before. He only had one eye. Somebody stuck him before. It's too bad. He can still hunt though. Oh, jeez. God, that thing killed it. That one came out of nowhere. He's got a big old hook scar on him, too. Thankfully, I didn't get him too bad. Somebody jacked him, though, right in the side of the cheek. That's pretty fresh, too, bud. That stinks. I didn't get you too bad, though. Came up from that grass right there and just hammered it. There's one. Came up and got it right before he got to the board, guys. He didn't look too good though. Pretty skinny. He is stunted. Y'all, there's that wild pig right there. You see him? Look, there he is. Oh, shit. Kind of looks like he wants to come in and get me. Oh my gosh. He wants a piece of me. I hope y'all can see him. I mean, he's right there, staring me down. There's one. Little bitty guy. I bet that pig would like to have this little bite-sized bass. There's another one. He's head shaking a little bit. Hopefully he stays on. Feels pretty good. Is he? Yeah, I think he's decent. Yeah, that's a decent one, guys. Alright. Y'all, I might stay for just a little bit longer, but he might be the last fish of the night. I've got maybe about 2 or 3 more minutes of light left. Y'all, that was supposed to be just a little like 1 hour trip to go out and see if my paddleboard was still holding there after I patched a couple of holes on it, and it turned into a slugfest. So I had known from previous, I'd fished that pond one time before and I knew there was some grass that grew from the bottom up. And when that happens, guys, that little Swank 66X is the perfect little crankbait to work through grass. So that grass was like 3 feet underneath of the water surface, like out in the middle where I was just kind of drifting around, guys. I would crank. Once I come in contact to the grass, I'd just like kind of tugging it through. Most of my bite came either right after the bait hit the water and I started to crank it, or as I got the bait down to the grass and I'd get it caught just a little bit and shake it out and then they'd hit it. And to my surprise, guys, we caught a really big one out of that pond. I mean, it wasn't a huge fish, but for a pond, that's a big fish, guys. And that pond sees a lot of pressure nowadays, guys. There's a ton of houses around it that didn't used to be there. And I saw 5 people come and go during the time that I was there. But my Dobbins 700C and that Cass King Zephyr with 8-pound fluoro was more than enough to sling this thing out there a mile and then work it with the proper action and handle some decent fish on it. So I was really happy with how that performed for me as well. If y'all enjoyed that one, leave a like for me. Consider subscribing if you haven't yet, guys, and talk with me down in the comments below. I enjoy going back and forth with y'all, and y'all take her easy. We'll catch you on the next one.